Maybe I see you working hard. Wanna let you know, I'm proud. Let you know that I admire what you do. Don't know if I need to reassure you, if my life will be purposeless without you. If I want it, when I ask you, you inspire me to be better. Challenge me for the better. Sit back and let me pour out my love letter. Let me help you. Take off your shoes, untie your shoestrings. Take off your cufflinks. Don't you wanna eat food? Let me feed you. Let me run your bath water. Whatever you desire, ask fire. Sing you a song. Turn the game on. I'll brush your hair.
Put your durag on.
Wanna put her up? Want a manicure? Baby, I'm yours. I wanna cater to you, boy.
Let me cater to you. Cause baby, this is your day. Do anything for my man. Baby, you blow me away. I got your slippers, your dinner.
Vixen, and this is Girl Talk. How I came about this podcast was I had seen a picture on Instagram, and it was a girl who had showed she was taking her dude out for his birthday, and she booked a hotel for his birthday. You know, she was showing his reaction and stuff like that, and he looked very happy, you know, was shocked, you know, like anybody would, that you didn't book the hotel. So, you know, I went on the page because I thought it was a beautiful thing to. It was on the Explore page, and I went on the page that I saw it was on to like it and put a heart up under, because like I said, I thought it was a cute gesture. I thought it was beautiful, and I love love. So when I went on her page and on the post, I wasn't expecting to see so many women and men, you know what I'm saying? But especially bitter ass women saying like, she dumb as hell. Why would you do that for a man? I bet you that man cheating on you. Oh, I would never do that for a man. And it's just like, I really wasn't expecting to see that. And it's just, it's always a woman. Anytime another woman is doing something for her man, it's always a woman trying to make her feel bad of doing it. Always trying to tell her, oh, you stupid for doing this for a man. And I don't understand how a woman that is doing something for a man that she is with, right? That she's with. It's dumb. And vice versa. I don't understand what a man taking care of his woman is dumb. I feel like when you are with somebody, like you're supposed to try to make them happy. And I don't mean just materialistic things of taking them out to hotels and buying them roses, but it's nothing wrong with making your significant other feel good. And just because it's a man, because I don't want it to be like it's just for women. Just because it's a man, men like to feel good too. Like, men are babies. Like, I don't care what nobody try to switch it. You know, men are stronger than women. And they might be. Men are supposed to be the head of the household and all of that. But men really are babies. They like to be spoiled. They like to be attentive to and all of that. So, and it's nothing wrong with spoiling your man. You know what I'm saying? Like, and I think that's weird. And women that be saying, oh, I would never do that for a man. Just say you wouldn't do it for your no good ass man. You wouldn't do it for the man that you with, cause your man ain't no good. Or just say, I can't see myself doing it, but maybe one day I can. You don't know what you're going to do in the future. You don't know if somebody, and the thing about, and the reason why I say you don't know what you'll do in the future, it is somebody out there that's ready to love you the way that you need to be loved, to cherish you, to appreciate you, to be attentive to you, to show you pure, honest, genuine love. And it's, you, like I said, it's a person out there that will show you, oh, I want to do something for this person. Now, yeah, if you get you a no good ass person that cheat on you, that talk about you like a dog, that beats on you and stuff like that, that you cannot trust behind your back. Hell no, you don't need to be getting that person a hotel. You don't need to be giving that person a kids meal at McDonald's if that's the case. So yeah, but I feel like that's like, I don't know, that's some bitter behavior. That's jealousy behavior. When you see beautiful things and stuff like that, like of a gift while you're out, or see some perfume, or when you're on Instagram and you see that vacation page that come up, yeah, you should think about, this is some place that I would like for my significant other to go to with me. Or if you see some shoes or a shirt that your husband like, oh, this would be something that he would like, you know? It don't even have to be something big. It could be, oh, my girlfriend, she loves spa days and stuff like that. She loves face masks. While I'm out, I can get her a face mask. And it's just a beautiful thing to do something for others. That should make you feel good. And I'm the type of person, I don't know if this is considered a toxic trait, but I'm just being real and honest right now. I'm the type of person that I would like to be able to get everything that my husband want. You know what I'm saying? Anything he tell me that he want or he need, I would like to get that for him. And where the toxic trait come in is that I'm the type of person, I don't care. This is bad to say. I don't care if it's the mom or the sister or the cousin. I want to be that person. I don't want none of them to do it. I feel like that makes me happy when my husband tell me that he wants something or, oh, I like that and I be able to get it for him. Like that makes me happy to make him happy that I be able to get him something. But I just truly feel that people that say that that's dumb for you to spoil and pamper someone that you are with, that you're in love with, that you're in like with, is wrong. And not only to the women, but I seen men on there like, I would never do this for a woman either. And I just feel like, yeah, like you just ain't met the woman. Like I said, like vice versa, you just haven't met the woman that will make you do something like that. I'm pretty sure her or him probably thought the same thing. Like, I would never do this for another woman. I would never do this for a man. And they made them feel a way where they wanted to make them feel special. So if you are with somebody that you know that is really a no good person, then yes, I understand why you wouldn't do nothing for them. But at the same time, some of y'all that was commenting, not to be shady or anything, but some of y'all that was commenting saying y'all would never, at the same time, y'all do like rewarding people that ain't no good. You know what I'm saying? And I feel like, If my man is making sure that I'm good, I can call him in case of emergency. And that's another thing. You shouldn't be fucking, sucking, getting nothing for nobody that you can't call in case of emergency. That's one. But if I can call my man in case of emergency and I know he's going to put me in a position where I am safe and he's going to handle it, where he's loving me the way I need to be loved, he's protecting me. And yeah. You know what I'm saying? He's cherishing me. He's adoring me, loving me the right way, teaching me the right way. And I feel that in my heart. I don't give a fuck what look dumb to somebody else. I'm going to try to spoil the fuck out of him. It might not be every week because I'm tight with a coin. It might not be every week and stuff like that. But when it comes to a birthday, when it comes to an anniversary, yeah, I show out. And I'm not just saying this on my podcast. Like, when I mean to tell y'all, I am the best gift giver. And everyone says that about me. Anything you say that you want, if me and you is cool, I'm going to try to get you that or even get you something even better than what you can imagine. I show out. And I'm a Leo woman. And one thing, I mean, like, everybody know that, if you don't know, like, if you look up our horoscopes, Leo women, we love helping others and we love gift giving and we're the best with gifts. Like, we pride ourselves with that. I ain't giving you no socks for your birthday. No, that's not me. Yeah. So I'm going to try to do the best that I can. And someone I love, I'm going to go hard for. I don't care about nobody saying I look stupid. And it's always somebody that say you look stupid. Also, this is another thing that I have to say. It's always somebody that say you look stupid who don't get no girlfriend, no wife, no boyfriend, no husband. It's always them people that be saying that. Y'all, you can't even compete where you can't compare. Like, you can't tell me what you wouldn't do when you ain't even in the situation. You not even with somebody. But, and it's always them people. They always got so much to say about somebody else, but they ain't never been in that position. You can't tell me it's stupid to do something for a man when you don't even have a man to do something for. Like, what? You know what I'm saying? Like, what? And you know, and I feel like sometimes we over-sexualize, sometimes we genderalize different things when we shouldn't do. You know, they make it seem like women are supposed to be materialistic. Women are supposed to be pampered, give roses and chocolate too, and being took out on dates. But men are supposed to always pay for the bill. And yes, women are supposed to be pampered in love. I am a woman and I'm not saying that at all. Okay. But it's nothing wrong with taking your man out on a date sometimes, you know, making him feel wanted. You know what I'm saying? Or, you know, just, you know, running him bath water, massaging him. I don't care what a man say, I'm not a female and stuff like that. I don't like being, you know, what men be saying with all of that dumbass shit. But men like to be pampered. They like to be spoiled. They like to be rubbed on, baby hair rubbed, feet rubbed. They like all of that. And I can care less what somebody say that I look dumb of. And I just felt like people have always told me like I live in a fairy tale world and stuff isn't like that because I speak very highly of love. You know what I'm saying? But, I don't think that's of a fairy tale world. Cause even when people be saying this is not like TV, you know, you think of love like TV. Where do y'all think people get stories from movies from about love? You don't think they was inspired by someone they loved or somebody they was with to make this movie, produce this movie? When people write books, you don't think somebody inspired them? When people draw art of beautiful people, it ain't always a model. It's probably somebody that inspired them that they was passionate about. So, yeah, if I'm basing love off of movies and stuff like that, I don't care because I think love is a beautiful thing. It's nothing wrong with spoiling your significant other. You are supposed to. It's not something that you just do when you court and woo somebody in the beginning. And that's another thing that people fail to realize, especially just like I said, it was more with women being bitter. Okay. When it comes to men feel like you are only supposed to woo women when it's in the beginning stage. Like, I guess, you know, trying to get in her pants or making them yours. And then once y'all got them, y'all stop doing it. And it's not that. You supposed to make your partner feel exactly the way they felt in the beginning. And I don't condone cheating. I think it's one of the most disgusting things in the world. But a lot of men and a lot of women say that the reason why they cheated is because they don't feel special no more. You know, I don't condone cheating. And I'm not saying it like they're not using that because it could be a lie. But I'm talking about people that tell the truth. A lot of people be like, oh, they didn't make me feel like I felt in the beginning. You know what I'm saying? They didn't do certain things. So I just wanted to make this podcast on, it's nothing wrong with spoiling men. It's nothing wrong with pampering men. But, you know, send me a message and let me know if I'm tripping. But you can send me a message on my podcast or DM me if you're following me on my Instagram, which is I am NunuVixen. I also made me a new Instagram, which is for my podcast. It is NunuVixen’sGirlTalk. You know, so if you would like to comment on this episode, go ahead and comment on it. But yeah, I am NunuVixen and this is Girl.